You can see a whale fin right there in the middle, buddy. See him splashing around?
Hello, family and friends, and welcome back. This is day 3 of our 7-night Mexican Riviera sailing on board Royal Caribbean's Navigator of the Seas, and we're in Cabo San Lucas today. If you'll be sailing to Cabo towards the end of November through April, be sure to be out on deck. You may get lucky enough to do some free whale watching. There was a pod of humpbacks that was very active while we were sailing in and getting ready to dock. It was so awesome to watch them.
Hello everyone, it is day 3. We are in Cabo San Lucas. We saw some beautiful humpback whales on the sail in, which was awesome without having to pay for an excursion. We are going to see what we can do about booking a shore excursion while we are in port after tendering over. So we'll see what the day brings.
Mistake number 1 for this port stop for us is don't assume you'll be able to purchase a shore excursion on board. In the past, we haven't had an issue purchasing shore excursions on board if we have not purchased them in advance. But now that ships are back to sailing at full capacity, we found we were totally out of luck for Cabo. The number of excursions and open spots for Royal Caribbean excursions for this port was limited. They sold out online, and when we asked about booking on board, the shore excursion staff said they were totally sold out.
Picture guys with the rings.
Definitely
totally deal with the pirate.
Mexican nose pony. I wonder where we'd be in there.
I feel like Mexican have plenty of alcohol.
Oh, it has something better than alcohol, but.
What is that? Lady, the last one.
El público está insistente, está dramático, el público, el frío, la navaja y la butaca.
Mistake number 2 is don't book with an independent provider in advance if they're not going to offer you flexibility. Cabo is a tender port, so you can't guarantee exactly when you'll be off the ship. With the key priority tendering, we were anticipating being off the ship and to shore by 1 p.m. Due to a technical issue with the aft gangway, we were stuck waiting for over 90 minutes and didn't arrive in Cabo until nearly 3:30 p.m. If we had pre-booked a shore excursion with an independent provider, we may have been out any deposit or booking fees paid for being that late.
So buddy, it looks like our Cabo trip today will be basically just walking around.
Okay.
What kind of fish was that inside?
¿Qué lo viste en el primer golpe de
you do what I mean? No, no.
Right to the arch?
No, thank you. Thank you, sir.
Mistake number three on our list is don't assume you'll be able to use credit cards. We had just come off a Greek Isles cruise the previous month where credit cards were readily accepted everywhere, even for the smallest of purchases like just buying a bottle of water. So we had left most of our cash in our cabin safe as we headed into Cabo, where we quickly realized that in order to book an excursion with any of the outfits in the port area, we needed cash, and lots of it. At all of the Mexican ports on this sailing, cash was king and credit cards were rarely accepted. Yes, there were ATMs at the dock area and we could have used them, but we had two bad experiences in the past year using ATMs while traveling, where fraudulent transactions showed up on our bank account shortly after, so we try to avoid using ATMs in foreign ports if possible. Hopefully you're able to better research some of these tour providers and figure out in advance what you want to do, how much you're willing to negotiate for it, and don't forget to bring plenty of cash. They accepted US dollars in this port as well as pesos.
How many want a snorkel?
I want a snorkel.
I'm sorry, you come from the other side. Perfect.
Come closer.
All right, give me a big smile, guys. Thumbs up. Bye. And now,
thank you.
Thank you.
Room number?
9273. Oh, she
Bye-bye.
again, everyone. So we are back from our time in Cabo. It was actually a bit of a bust. The day did not go as planned at all. Not that we had much of a plan for starters. So first thing is that we did not have a shore excursion booked through Royal Caribbean because we waited too long to book it, and it sold out. When we got on board, typically in the past, we have not had any problems purchasing a shore excursion on board. This time that was not the case. They were totally sold out for all shore excursions on board in Cabo, at least the ones that we wanted to do and were interested in. So we thought we would maybe look at doing one through Viator or another reputable source online, but we weren't sure what time we were going to be docking and with the tendering process what time we would actually be getting into port, so we didn't purchase in advance, thinking we would just buy day of once we were sure of our arrival time. That was another mistake because turns out you can't actually buy those tickets through those particular agencies for those specific tours online same day. Those had also sold out or just were not available. So then our plan C for the day was to just take the tender over and try to actually just purchase those tickets for the tour that we wanted to do directly while we were there, and that turned out to be a little overwhelming of a process. First, the tender process through the key. We were supposed to have priority tender access. They asked us to meet down at Bolero's at 12:30, by 12:30. We actually got down there, was it 12:10 p.m., something like that? We got down there at 12:10 p.m. It was super crowded. They'd already started handing out tender tickets long before 12:10 p.m. We received tender group 4 tickets. They'd already handed out 1, 2, and 3 to members of the key that had arrived long before we did. They started calling people down, but we waited until almost 1:50 p.m. Before they started calling groups 3 and 4. And then once we started to move, we waited on the stairs and waited on the stairs some more and waited a bit more. And then they finally made an announcement saying that they were having a technical issue with the area where we were supposed to be getting off the ship with the aft gangway. Only the forward gangway was working properly at that time. So we probably hung around for another 30 minutes before we started moving again. The tendering process was a little bit crazy. It was probably one of the rockiest experiences we've ever had. You know, we haven't sailed with other cruise lines, only with Royal Caribbean, so our experience with this whole process is really limited. So we do have some video of what that process was like, but if you are not sure-footed, as I am definitely not, that could be challenging. I would definitely recommend rubber-soled shoes so that you don't slip. It was a little bit rocky. The tender ride itself was probably only about 10 minutes over to port, but once we got off, it was just very, very overwhelming. As soon as you get off of the tender boat, there are people just in your face constantly like shouting, you know, glass bottom boat tour, do you want to do this tour, that tour, you know, water taxi, just from multiple directions, just people like just in your face trying to sell you stuff. You know, right as you get off the dock. There were other stands that were available. We walked around for a bit trying to see if we could find a couple of the companies that I'd researched on TripAdvisor that were rated highly. We could not find their offices near the dock. And Raj was feeling kind of tired and overstimulated and overwhelmed and just wanted to come back to the ship. He was pretty much done between the 2.5 hour wait to get on the tender to get into port and trying to find a shore excursion. The shore excursion that we wanted to do was actually to just take a boat ride to see the arch in Cabo, which is kind of the thing to do, kind of a coastal cruise. So we missed being able to do that. Yes, Raj?
I will say the tendering, like getting on and off the tender on the ship was a little rocky, but from the actual tender boat itself going to and from the port was actually like best tender experience I've had.
That's good to know that it was not an uncomfortable ride. Thank you for that. Yeah, so we came back to the ship. We had a super late lunch at Playmakers and just rested and decompressed for a bit. So our don't of visiting Cabo is don't make the same mistakes we did and make sure that you have a plan for your day. And even when you have a backup plan, have a backup to the backup plan and some idea of what you want to do and research some of the more reputable local vendors. We did take some video of the different vendor stalls that were in port. So if you don't have a Royal Caribbean Shore excursion book, or something through Viator or some other outlet, and you need to purchase something while you are on shore, you can maybe do some research for those companies in advance and figure out, you know, which way you'd like to go. Yeah. So with that, we are going to be heading to dinner soon and then ice skating show tonight. And yeah, we'll see what the night brings.